I'm Max.
Hi, and I'm Denise.
And I'm Tyler.
And welcome to another edition of Urban Lifestyles. As you can see, our third wheel is still with us, and we're glad to have you home still.
Thank you.
So we've got a great show today, and Tyler, since you've been here, you've been doing a lot of work. So what are the two segments we got for this week?
Okay, we have Mark Gunn up next. He's celebrating 10 years at V96.
Wow.
33 years in the game, but 10 years at V96, so it's definitely a mile marker, and I had a chance to sit down with him and interview him and just see his take on his time at B96 and what he thought about the industry and where it's all going.
Okay.
It was interesting.
All right, so take a look at this.
Blazing hip hop at R&B, it's B96.5, how you living? It's Mark Gunn. Make sure you check us out online for all the hot new stuff. You can get a hold of us at B96jams.com. Check us out on Facebook or on Twitter at The Real B96.5. More hip-hop and R&B on the way next. Slow Oval's B96.5.
Well, you just heard it here first, Mark Gunn. And I don't know how long you've been living here, how long you have been alive, but it has been 10 years.
Yes, ma'am.
For you on B96.
Mm-hmm.
10 years.
10 years.
A decade.
A decade.
I would be 14. So I know I've been listening because that was all my thing. B96, 14.
Wow.
That's my target. I'm still on the target. So.
Right. Yes, you are.
So I've been listening to you for 10 years.
You've grown up with me.
Yes, I know your voice.
Wow.
It was very natural for me to hear that, and now to see it in person.
Right.
It's exciting,
right.
And his voice sounds like how you would look. Like it makes sense. You know how sometimes you hear people's voice and it doesn't match. You match.
See now. That is a question that I've always wanted to get the answer to, because for years I've always heard that, well, you don't look like you sound. Well, then, first of all, what does that mean? And secondly, what am I supposed to look like? I've had everything from 6'8" and 300 pounds.
Negative.
To 5'10", 180 pounds, blonde hair, blue eyes. It's just been crazy. So the nearest I can figure is you know, and one of the beauties of radio,
mm-hmm.
is we are definitely theater of the mind.
Yes.
So whatever mental picture you have in your head when you hear us, that's what it is. But with the advent of the internet and all kinds of interactive media, you don't have that imagination so much to rely on, because you could see us as well
see
as
you.
Hear us.
And you're always out on the town,
mm-hmm.
and out and about. And at every party, and at every place. So, not in a bad way, in a good way. You're on the scene. So,
exactly.
We know Mark, we see Mark. And it's probably because I do see him all the time. I just, but I can say this too. I know some people, when I'm in the studio with them and I hear them, and then they talk to me regularly, it's a totally different voice.
Yeah.
You keep it the same. And I like that.
And
it's not different.
And that's been I think that's been one of the secrets to my success for the last 33 years.
33.
Is that, you know, when you start in this business, there are basics that you learn about being a DJ, disc jockey, radio personality.
Mm-hmm.
And then the really good ones unlearn everything that they've ever been taught.
Oh.
And it's about being who you are. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, the analogy I like to use is radio is like professional wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
The most successful pro wrestlers are the ones that are themselves, instead of having some fake gimmick, because people can relate to them.
Mm-hmm.
And we are pretty much the same way.
The same way.
If what you see and what you hear is what you get when you see us on the street, if we're that consistent, it's going to be easier for you to relate to us.
Exactly.
Not only, you know, not as this elevated celebrity type,
exactly.
but as a regular person.
Exactly. You can take someone seriously. You can appreciate what they have to say. The way you present yourself has always been good. Now, I was going to say the famous DJ, and then I was going to say famous radio host. I know it kind of gets a little confusing there, but we're going to take a break and come back and really get down to what is he, a DJ or a radio host, and what is the difference? We'll be right back with more Urban Lifestyles. Okay, we're back with Mark Gunn, celebrating 10 years, 10, at B96, and 10 wonderful years.
Yes.
Love it.
Yes.
But we left talking about DJ versus radio personality. What is the difference?
To me, there really is no difference, but this whole thing got started as soon as we really stopped playing vinyl.
Okay.
Because when radio started, disc jockeys, DJs, we actually spun vinyl records on turntables.
Mm-hmm.
And so yeah, just like a regular horse jockey, we were disc jockeys.
Disc jockeys.
And over time, as radio evolved,
mm-hmm.
There were some in technology and the whole mm-hmm. nine yards. There were some in the business that took offense to being called DJs or disc jockeys because they were radio personalities.
Oh.
And, you know, yeah. I always thought that was a bunch of garbage because, mm-hmm. you know, the DJ is at the very heart, the very essence of who we are
yeah.
and what we do. I mean, if all this technology ended tomorrow, we would go back to playing that vinyl.
And it's still about the music.
And it is still always about the music. So to me, it's like, call me a DJ, call me a radio personality, call me whatever. Just spell my name on the check roll.
I know that's you know? Right. Okay, so 10 years in radio.
Yes.
You went over, you know, disc jockey to radio personality, but just in the radio, in here, mm-hmm. in itself, how has that changed in 10 years that you've been here?
The biggest changes have been technological.
Okay.
We've gone from playing CDs and records and these 8-track looking contraptions to being totally computer based.
Right.
We've got huge music databases, commercial databases. Everything is networked and interactive. The knowledge that you have got to gain to keep yourself relevant, the game is always changing. So the more technologically savvy you become,
mm-hmm.
the more relevant you are in the business.
Wow.
But what hasn't changed is the importance of the radio personality in that he or she is the connection to the community.
Exactly.
He or she is, in a lot of radio markets,
mm-hmm.
the closest thing to a Hollywood celebrity that you're going to have. Television has that to a certain extent, but it's limited because most of your local television personalities are in news.
Exactly.
And as great a job as they do, they're somewhat limited in what they can do and the types of things that they can do.
Exactly.
Whereas we as disc jockeys, radio personalities, DJs, can be reflections of the lifestyle.
Exactly.
In our case, the urban lifestyle. Like you mentioned, the parties, different events, social occasions, you know, just anything and everything connected with the community, we have an inside plug to.
You're
because
in
we're
it.
Able to do it, right? Mm-hmm. Exactly.
And I can say this too: music, more than news and more than the newscasters and things like that, music is everyone's connection. I don't think there's one person mm-hmm. out there who can say, "I don't have a favorite song or a favorite style of music."
Right,
music is just so powerful.
Mm-hmm.
But on an even better note, speaking about music. You're a DJ, a radio personality, you know music. So mm-hmm. what is that one song that is just like, when you just hear it, it doesn't matter what your mood is,
mm-hmm.
it doesn't matter what you're doing. Like, I call it my driving down the Pacific coast in my convertible song. Just
right,
what is that
right.
song for you? Everyone has one. You're the master. What's yours?
You know, for me, let me back up a little bit because the other connection that I have with music is as a musician.
Oh, yes.
Second generation musician. I'm also a record producer
mm-hmm.
and a music consultant. So I'm coming at this from a totally different perspective than the average person.
Exactly.
I have those different types of songs.
Mm-hmm.
There's not one particular for me.
Okay.
Because of my taste in music, it is so diverse.
Okay.
That, and it's not like I'm always looking for something new. I'm just looking for something that makes me feel,
mm-hmm.
you know, whatever it is that I want to feel. So there's not one particular song for me.
Okay.
It's just a whole lot of
songs. I'll take that. But the key we can take away from this is that there is music that just makes you feel.
Exactly.
It doesn't matter. It just, And I can't say that different moods because
mm-hmm.
I have my driving down the Pacific Coast Highway and then I have my just chilling. But music makes you feel. You make all of Louisville feel. For 10 years at B96, it's so appreciative. And I'm always appreciative to be in your presence because you're just such a music master.
Oh, anytime. Nah, you know, it's just,
if you're in something that you love, you're going to soak up as much knowledge as you possibly can about it.
And
Exactly. And if you love what you do, it's like, you know, they always say, you never work a single day in your life.
Tyler, that was a great piece you did. And Mark is definitely an asset to the community. A couple of weeks ago, we got to go to his surprise birthday party, and he was totally surprised. But he does really some great work in the community.
And speaking of surprises, you know, the way he talks, it has sort of like an accent. It's Northern. I couldn't figure it out. And just learning that he's an Air Force brat, I guess that's what you call it. His dad was in the Air Force for a career, and they lived in places like Idaho. And
he has seen the world.
And how his sisters and them say that he was the one that introduced them to diversity of music.
So Mark, keep up the great work. We'll take a quick break and back with more of Urban Lifestyles right after this.
John Benton had requested a face-to-face meeting with the wife of Muhammad Abdelrahman and representatives of the Sudanese community. They granted his request, and we're going into Metro Corrections to see what he has to say about his potential involvement in the death of Muhammad Abdelrahman. The family and the community has went through a great deal of pain. He was a wonderful human being. He has two little girls. They miss their father dearly.
This is clearly a meeting about you, John Benton. They fully understand that, and that's where our focus lies. But the mere fact that they came here is a testimony of strength on their part, but equally, we respect you trying to come forth and reveal to whatever you can reveal to them about your involvement in the death of Muhammad Abdelrahman.
Called AIDS, acquired immune deficiency syndrome, sounds less than deadly, more like a diet pill. AIDS has struck only a reported 1,500 people, but it has killed almost 600 of them.
If this were happening to you in the white, straight, middle-class community, it would have been attended to a long time ago.
Congress wants to know what to do about AIDS. Victims of the disease say the government has done nothing and has no plan to.
The government today tried to reassure people that there's no evidence AIDS is breaking out into the general population. Assistant Secretary for Health, Edward Brandt.
What's important is that there is no reason for panic.
The gay plague, as AIDS has been called, is the center of a political storm. The moral majority claiming AIDS is God's punishment for the gay lifestyle.
All this media attention and sympathy for these AIDS victims just really bothers me. Let's call a spade a spade. AIDS is a venereal disease, and the vast majority of its victims are a group of abnormal people with a very strange and unusual lifestyle.
Parents were afraid three brothers, Ricky, Robert, and Randy Ray, all hemophiliacs, would spread the AIDS virus they got from blood products.
Just been infected with HIV.
I'm Matt, and I've just been infected with HIV.
I'm Nelson, and I've just been infected with HIV.
I'm Michelle. I've just been infected with HIV.
I'm George, and I've just...
I'm Janet, and I've just been infected with HIV.
What's the deal, Ma? I seen you eyeing me.
Yeah, I've been watching.
Can I call you?
I got it ready for you.
What's up with this HIV hotline?
You better check yourself. This ain't no game.
Just want to talk to you.
I'm HIV positive. I didn't protect myself. You still want to talk?
I didn't know.
If you are sexually active, there's only one way to protect yourself for sure. Use condoms correctly every time. Life is what you make it. Be safe.
Now they ride and live together, life they can live it better, just knowing. A love they created and made, now neither of them is afraid, just knowing. That they got each other's back, and respect is an action, not an act, now knowing. Each other they embrace, in love and it's safe, now knowing. Knowing is beautiful.
How you doing? It's Mark Gunn on Louisville Speed 96.5. And you know when you find something that you really like, you want to turn other people on to it. And that's exactly the case with me and Wheat Thins, 11 grams of whole grain per 31-gram serving. Now, I went to a party with some friends of mine this past weekend, and it got a little bit crazy when I'm trying to get them to break out of the old boring bag routine.
All right, wait a minute. Whoa. Hold up. What you doing, Lola? What you doing? What's this?
Spinach queso.
And then what is that you get ready to put on your spinach queso? What is that right there? Yeah, what's that?
Chip?
Oh, no. Hold up. Give me that. See that?
Wait.
No, here's what you need.
Oh.
See what that is? Wheat Thins.
Okay, thanks, Mark.
Wheat Thins. How's it taste? Sun-dried tomato and basil, baby.
I really like those.
See, so you got Wheat Thins.
Why threw my chips on the
And I threw your chips.
Why am I eating your chips?
Why are you eating your chips?
Oh. All of my
paperwork. Oh, wait. Lolo? I'm going to have one of these.
These are
he's here.
Those there.
Sun dried tomato and basil.
Vegetable.
What's this?
Vegetable flavored cream cheese and vegetables.
Anyway. Oh.
Wheat thins. Go to your favorite grocery store. See, I love it. See, that just looks so good.
Well, as you can see, some of my friends can be a little bit on the crazy side, but they get it. No more unsatisfying snacks. No more boring bags. They're into the whole grain crunch of Wheat Thins. And they've got a wide assortment of flavors for you to check out, too, okay? Wheat Thins. The crunch is calling.
Welcome to B96Jams.com and Mark Gunn's Hip Hop Chronicles, where we take a look back at some of the greatest names in rap by giving you biographical information and some rarely seen music videos. Kind of a hip-hop history lesson. Now, you know you can't do something like this without talking about the very first group to make it to the rap mainstream. The Sugar Hill Gang, Big Bank Hank, Master G, Wonder Mike, formed in 1977 in New York City by Sylvia Robinson, who was a record executive along with her husband Morris. They wanted to record the first rap record. They named the group after the record label, Sugar Hill Records. They went into the studio, Rapper's Delight was born, released in 1979, and one of the hugest records to this day. Rapper's Delight was such a huge record because domestically, it sold over 2 million units and over 8 million worldwide. It was the first rap record to be featured in regular daytime airplay. It was also, unfortunately, the first rap record to be involved in a copyright infringement lawsuit because it used Good Times, recorded by Chic, as a sample, and as you probably already know, they didn't get permission to do it, and they ended up costing them a whole lot of money. So, Sugar Hill Gang still around, they're still doing tours every now and then, but I thought it would be cool for you to take a look at the very first video that launched rap into the mainstream. Sugar Hill Gang, Rapper's Delight, Mark Gunn's Hip Hop Chronicles on B96Jams.com.